So today we'll talk about the octant rule, which is used in describing or in explaining the positive and negative quantum effect phenomenon in optically active cyclohexanone compounds which are substituted. Now in the last lecture we have talked about the axial haloketone rule, which was simple, that any halogen will be placed in the axial position near to the carbonyl, and then we have to look through the carbonyl. If it is in the right side, then we have positive quantum effect. If it is in the left side, then negative quantum effect. But this octant rule will generalize everything. That means whether it does not depend on the particularly halogen substituent, put any substituent, and then based on their position, one can easily tell that what will be the quantum effect in that particular compound. Now, first of all, that why it is octant rule. Now, here this whole space in carbonyl compound like cyclohexanone will be divided into 8 parts. I will show how it is dividing, and then you will know that since it is dividing the whole space in 8 parts, that's why it's octant. Octants means 8. So from 8 it is coming the name. So octant rule. We have this carbonyl. Now this carbonyl will have its own plane. This is one plane. This is one plane of the carbonyl. Apart from that, what are the other planes present in that carbonyl? We know that carbonyl has this lone pair of electrons. So we will write this lone pair of electrons. Now this is also that one side it is positive and this side negative. So this is, there is a present of node, and based on that, so this will represent like, let's say this is the up portion of this plane and here is the down part. That means it is perpendicularly present. You can see, look at this diagram. So this is the perpendicular presentation. So one is the mole, this carbonyl itself has one plane, and then the it is due to the presence of node of that lone pair of electrons or that one perpendicular plane. Now we know this carbonyl, this has antibonding pi star orbital. One moment. That C, this is antibonding plus minus minus plus. So we can think of a nodal surface through this in between. So this nodal surface we will talk about because it's a largely extended, so it is the surface. Because it is present in between this pi star, and we'll take this as a plane. So basically what is the conclusion here is that we have total 3 planes which are perpendicular. Let's think it or visualize it one more time, that we have first this carbonyl, it has this pi type of bonding, which is plus, minus and minus. So it has this bonding, and through this we have a, because plus to minus, so there is a node. So this is on the molecular plane. So this is one nodal length, which is bisecting this pi molecular orbital. Now, another is that we have this carbonyl and it has this lone pair of electron, let's say plus minus. So this will be bisected perpendicularly. That means this is another nodal then through node. Node is present here, like node was present here. So here it is the node. So another nodal plane, which is just perpendicular. So this plane on the molecular plane and the other one, which is bisecting the lone pair of orbital, that is another nodal plane. So this is for the lone pair, and this one for the pi, and the third one, that oxygen and carbon, this is the carbonyl, and it has this pi star. And we know the symmetry of the pi star, that this is plus, this is minus, and this is plus. So there will be another plane here present. Actually, it is a surface, nodal surface, but it is, we'll think about it, nodal plane. So total three plane. One is like this on the molecular plane, which is through the nodal plane of the pi bonding orbital. And then we have this, this for the lone pair, this nodal plane. So two plane you can see correctly, and the third one will be like this. So if we consider these two only, this already dividing. So we have, let's say, one plane on the molecular plane and another one this is just perpendicular. So it is already dividing the whole space into four parts. So one will be this part, this will be another two, and that side corner there will be third one, and here in the below that is fourth one. So you can see it like this, and then we have four parts already. We have divided the space into four parts, and the last one, this one, if we write this one also like this, then you can see that yes, it is dividing the whole space into eight parts. So since it is dividing the whole space into eight parts, that's why the rule octant is coming. So main concept is here that there are three different nodal plane based on the orbitals, pi orbital, pi star orbital, and this n type orbital, which is the lone pair. So three orbitals gives three types of nodal plane, and they are perpendicular to each other, and they are dividing the whole space into eight parts. That's why the rule, octant rule, is coming. Now we will talk about that why this, after dividing this eight parts, what is the specialty, what we get out of this. So here you see that after dividing, that three planes are now perpendicular. This is one plane, this is another, and this is the third one. So these three planes are perpendicular, and now we have eight quadrant. So they different eight regions in the space. So we denote according to the main who developed this method, Gerasi, that this part will be negative and this is positive. This is positive, this is negative. So this is the notation by him, that this is how he developed the rule, that this will be negative, this part will be negative, this will be positive, this will be positive, this will be negative, and just oppositely. Like here, if we know one corner, the whole thing will be known. The first corner of this is negative, then the side by corner, this one will be positive, and it's nearby, is this one is also positive, the opposite one is the negative. And then if we move from this to this, this is also opposite, so positive, and then here in the corner there is positive, and this side it is negative and negative. And now the projection, we generally look into the rear part. This one is called the front, which is in which side the carbonyl present. This is called the front octet, and this part is called the rear octet. So this is the front octet and this is the rear octet. In the rear octet, you see this part, we are looking from this side to that molecule, this carbonyl or cyclohexanone compound. Now, if we look from this side, so this is positive and this is positive, this is negative, this is negative. So that's what we have written. In most of the cases, the rear part will be important, because I will show that why the rear part is important. And this is the rear projection formula. And based on this, we can tell that what will be the effect, water effect. So again, I have shown this part to understand. Now place this is the carbonyl, and now we are placing the cyclohexanone. You see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now this part is positive, this part is negative, this part is also positive, and the other part is negative. So that's what is written now here. Now you have to understand how the projection is done. So here, what is done here is that look into that molecule. That we have this, if we look from this side through z-axis, so first we will see this oxygen. In the right side, we have this carbon number 2. And in the left side, we have this carbon number 6. And this carbon number 2 is bonded to carbon number 3. And carbon number 6 is bonded to carbon number 5. And this 3 is bonded to 4. And 5 is also bonded to 4. So that's what is written here. Now you can, according to the rule, you must do it like this. So this, in the main original work, that person or that scientist represent it in that way. So, and then you can have this axis also. Z axis is through this oxygen. And y-axis, this is the y-axis, and this is the x-axis. So this plane is the xz plane, and this plane is the yz plane, the molecular plane, and this is the xz plane, and this is the yz plane. So these are the three different planes. So first one, this, the main plane, this is the yz plane and this is the xz plane. So yz, xz, and the final one, this one is the x. 1 minute, this yz, the molecular plane is the yz plane and this is the xz plane. Then that's all you have to remember. And that will be the XY plane, this one, the opposite. So three planes basically, YZ, XZ and XY. Three axes present there. And now the right view, how when you get this cyclohexanone molecule, how you should look at the molecule to get this projection formula in terms of octet rule. So this is okay. This you can view in this way, that this is carbonyl projected in that direction, upward direction, but this is not true. Okay, you cannot view the molecule in that way. So oxygen should be projected to that our side through which we are looking at the molecule. This is also fine, that if we make it little bit tilt, because actually we look at the molecule in that way, or this is okay, but when the oxygen is down, like this one or this one, this is not the right position. We cannot view the molecule in that way. So we can tell that this is okay. This is also okay, but this is not, this is not. And then we take this molecule Let's take this molecule, and that now you see the projection is properly shown here. Then you can visualize more. So this is the carbonyl present, and this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different these carbon atoms are shown. Now this is oxygen. How the projection is coming? Look at this. This one carbon number one is going here, and this is attached to oxygen. So we can write this oxygen carbon number. This is going this here. This naming is 6, so it is 6 is going there, and 2 is going there, and hence 3 is will be this one, 4 will be this middle one, and 5 will be this one, and then it is shown in this projection. And this is the rear one. Rear is this positive, and negative, and negative. That's what is shown: positive, negative, and negative. So this is also okay. Now again, I want to show that how it is coming, so you there will be no doubt in the octane group. So this is the front side is the negative. Front octet is just opposite to the rear. So this is negative, positive, negative, positive. That's what it is shown. In the diagonal, there is negative. In the this diagonal, there will be positive. And this will be exactly opposite in the rear. Rear is C, this diagonal is positive, and this diagonal is negative. So this is the this is one example with the saturated ketone. The octet rule, the left the nodal planes of the chromophore define 8 octets. This chromophore is dividing these 8 octets, that we know how the 3 different planes are present, and they are dividing whole space into 8 regions. And this is again the projection, so that there is no confusion. So this is projected, this carbon is, first of all, this carbon is projected here. So carbon we cannot see in the front, there is, because we are looking at this from this side, looking at the molecule from this side. Like this is the molecule, and we are looking from this side. And then this is the oxygen, which is shown here, and this carbon projected here, this carbon projected there, this middle carbon projected in this place, and this is this place, and this is there. Actually, there is no bond between oxygen and this. Actually, for the way of representation, this is how the original paper, because all the 3 planes, 1, 2, and all these planes, they are perpendicular to each other, and particularly here, this plane and this plane, they are bisecting. So this bisecting one is shown here, this by this line. And in the rear place, we have this positive, negative, and negative. Now you see that if we place this methyl, we have now extra methyl in this cyclohexane. Now this methyl will be written like this. This is like an equatorial one, and this equatorial is shown like this. If it is axial, if it would have axial, then it would have been placed like this. Now the main thing is that when the methyl is placed here, it is in the positive part, positive region. So this will show the positive part of it. This is the main rule. When first we have to define the mainly rear octet, we know that this diagonal positive, and this is negative. And once we know the structure and project it like this simple projection, and we have to look where the substituent is present, whether it is in the positive part or negative part. If it is in the positive part, then it will show positive quaternary effect. If it is in the negative part, then it will show negative quaternary effect. Now, some summarization of the octane rule is that substituents in the back lower right and back upper left, how it is coming, I will show that. Let's come into the picture, otherwise you cannot visualize this. So what it is saying, that substituent in the back lower right, rear, this is the rear octet, that's why positive and negative, back lower right, this one, and back upper left, this one, these octants make positive contribution. This is okay. And these substituents in the back lower left, and back upper right, they will make negative contribution. Then substituents lying in any of the planes dividing the octants make no contribution. If this substituent present in the planes bisect, that is any of this nodal plane, because we know in the node, you remember that when any of this curve, any of the curve is going like this. So this is zero through nodal plane. That's why when any substituent present in the nodal plane, then it will have no contribution. So for example, this represents one nodal plane. This represents one nodal plane. This represents one nodal plane. If substituent present here, then there will be no contribution to the quaternary. Now substituent lying in any of the plane dividing the octant makes no contribution. There are three planes. If it belongs to any of this plane, there is no contribution. So this one will have no contribution, and if it is placed in this place, there will be no contribution. The contribution of a substituent is more important the closer it is to the, if let's say we have this cyclohexane molecule, now this is the cyclohexanone. Now substituent can be here, here or here. So 1, 2, 3 and 4, more is it closer, so effect will be 2 > 3 > 4. That is, in this, nearer it is to the carbonyl, it will have more effect, because it can interact directly. It is more closer to the carbonyl, so it can perturb this carbonyl electronic transition much more, N2-pi transition. That's why closer it is, more is the effect. Major perturber is the first carbon. That's the same thing it is saying, that the major perturber is the first carbon in the alkyl perturber. That means this one. This one is the first one, which is the major, which will have the major contribution. Now here are some examples of placing the substituents. So this is one at this 1, 2 and 3 position, we have substituent. Now we can have axial orientation or equatorial. Now this is first one is the equatorial. So it is, if we look into the molecule from this side, we are looking at the molecule, our eye, and from this side. And so this is in the right side, this one, and this is equatorial. So first we are writing the projection. This is the oxygen, and this is one bond, two bond, this is one, two, and then they are going up, up, and then they will again join. And now at the right position, at here, at this corner, it is projected this side. All right. And so this is present in the negative region. So this will give negative Cotton effect. Negative Cotton effect. CE means Cotton effect here. And then we have this axial. This axial will be just upward. Just look into the molecule. So you have oxygen, then two bonds, two side, two bond, then upper and this upper, this one and this one, and then these two are joined at this carbon. These two are joined at this carbon. And here at this carbon, we have this axial. So this is the axial substituent present here. Now look at the difference only. This is axial just placed in the up, and equatorial in the right side it is placed. And here also you will have this negative Cotton effect. Now two substituent at the two position. Now this can be also equatorial and axial. Now this is equatorial one. So here we are looking at this molecule, and then we are placing this X, this one here, we are placing it here. Because it is equatorial. Whenever it is in the equatorial, it will be near to this plane. Like either to this line, near to this line, or near to this line. If it is axial, either it will be like this or it will be like this in the perpendicular way, not in the horizontal way, in the vertical way, not in the horizontal way. Whenever it is in the equatorial, it will be in the horizontal way. If it is in the axial, then it will be in the vertical way. So as you can see that this one is coming at the right position, and this is in the horizontal way. But now the point comes. Here we know at this place there is a plane present. You remember that when we did all the projection near to this carbonyl, there is a plane. This YZ plane is present. Since it is present in the nodal plane, so it will have very less contribution. So very small Cotton effect it will show. As again it is shown this one, this projection is shown it here, and we can, that means when we look from this side, how it will actually look like this, and then we can think of like this, and it is near to this nodal plane, so it will have small Cotton effect. But when this, so this is with the equatorial two position, but two position axial, this is in the positive side, so it will have large positive Cotton effect because it is not in the nodal plane, it is perpendicular to the nodal plane. And now the fourth one is substituent. So we discussed substituent at the three position, substituent at two position. So this is at the three position, this is at the two position, and this is now we are discussing at the four position. So four position again axial and equatorial, but it will have no contribution since this is also, you remember, so there are three planes. One, this is YZ plane, then we have XZ plane, and then XY plane. So this one, this fourth one is present in the this plane, that means XZ plane. It is present in this X. If you look at this will be present in a nodal plane. So fourth substituent, just remember that fourth substituent will have no contribution. And similarly, substituent at two position, like here, or if it is, we consider six position, substituent at two and six position, if it is in the equatorial, it will have less contribution, small contribution, because it will be near to a nodal plane. And the preferred conformation, now we are applying these different rules, that here we have this three position methyl equatorial, and also three position, this, it can be axial. Now three position, when it is in the equatorial, our projection will be, it will be, if we look at from this side, so it is in the left side, this methyl, so it is, it will be have positive Cotton effect, positive C. If we take this conformation, and if we take this conformation, but remember, we cannot look into that way. We have to rotate the molecule. So that's why this is the same molecule, but it is now, it is, this axial is present in the left side. Now when, if we rotate just 180 degree, then this carbonyl will be this side. So we can look at the molecule from this side, and then it is our front, and at the right side, axial position, we have methyl. So axial position methyl, and this is will have negative Cotton effect. This is the rule. So this will be positive Cotton effect. Now, experimentally, this compound, this R plus 3 methyl cyclohexanone exhibit a positive Cotton effect. So this R plus 3 methyl cyclohexanone exhibiting a positive Cotton effect. That means it must be, this is the conformation, right conformation. So indicate clearly the preferred conformer is the equatorial one. So equatorial one is the preferred conformation. And indeed, we know that it is in the equatorial, there is less 1,3 diaxial interaction. So most of the conformer wants to present in the equatorial one. So R plus 3 methyl cyclohexanone, and also remember, last lecture I have told that to identify the third one, we must know the substituent or configuration or conformation. Any two we have to know, then the third one we can tell. So for example, here R plus 3 methyl cycloic phenol, we know this configuration and constitution. Then we can tell this conformation. So if we know two things, then third thing we can tell using this ORD, that is optical rotary dispersion or CD spectroscopy. That is whether there is positive protonated or negative protonated. Then again the same thing, that whether it is axial position or in the equatorial position. Like here it is equatorial and then here it is axial. The same thing, the previous example. And you can write the projection when it is equatorial, then it is negative. When it is axial, then it is negative, because you have to rotate this molecule again and it will come in the right side, and it is now in the axial position and it is in the equatorial position. And again, this is for the R isomer and this is for the S isomer, because these are two enantiomer possible, because this center is chiral center. Four different substituents are present. So we have two enantiomer. This is R and this is the S. In practice, it is found that with the R, this equatorial is the most preferred conformation, and it shows this positive coordinate. So R is the, if we take this R methyl cyclohexanone, R3 methyl cyclohexanone, then this is the right conformation, that is this one. And if we take this S3 methyl cyclohexanone, S3 methyl cyclohexanone, this equatorial, it will show negative coordinate. So this is the case. So if we take R3 methyl cyclohexanone, then it will show positive coordinate effect. If we take S3 methyl cyclohexanone, then it will show negative coordinate. And 10 methyl decalone, this is the examples with 10 methyl decalone. Here you know this decaline, and in the decaline, if we place double bond O, then it becomes decalone. So in decalone, this one is the trans one and it can have the cis one. So 10 methyl decalone. So decalone, we give the name, and this is the 10 position, and this is also for the 10 position. So it can have two structure, either a trans one or a cis one. So this is the representation for the trans one, you know, and also this, and these are opposite to each other. And this is the trans conformation. Now, if you look at the molecule from this, so this is the same thing will come, this double bond O. And at this position, we have this extra methyl group is attached at this 10 number of carbon. That methyl is shown here. And if you see this 5, now carbon number 10 and 5, there is this bond 5 and 10. And with that, we have this 9, and other side, this one is going. So that's all. Since in the left side, we have further extension of this thing. You can visualize and you can do it by yourself. So since there is a further extension, and now if you look at the octant rule, again, you have to draw that. You know, this is positive, this is positive, this is negative, this is negative. So this is belongs to the positive side. This whole part is in coming in the positive side. So it will show positive coordinate. So this is with the trans one. Now, if you take the cis one, this is the cis conformation and this is the conformation. Here, again, you have to project this molecule. You have to look at the molecule from this side. And this is same thing, but now it is in the right side. So this substituent, now this bond is this one, and to that one is present this, and this is another one, this is another one, and this bond. So these are all shown here. You can do it by yourself. It's simple how I saw the previous one. In the same way, so since it is in the right side, so right side, if you, this is minus minus plus plus. So this part is coming here. So it will show negative cotton effect. And you can write it in a different projection formula also. Still, this is if you because you know that trans have fixed conformation, but cis can have two different conformation. It can flip. It can undergo flipping, and then if you flip it, then you can get another conformation which has almost nearly zero cotton effect or weak cotton effect, because it is belongs to the near to the nodal plane. It will come. That's why it will show very low cotton effect. But mainly this is the important conformation. And this is the spectra for the 11 one. As you can see, positive cotton effect. And here this is for the negative cotton effect. This dotted one. Positive means here it is increasing and here it is decreasing. So that's all. And the final one is with the ketosteroid, and ketosteroid also this if possible, then I will further extend these examples in the next lecture because we are running out of time. So you in the PDF, you try by yourself. I will supply the PDF. So again, I will discuss in the next lecture.